Steve, just realized that I went all this time without giving advice to caregivers of a difficult patient. Let's see, where could I find a difficult patient? Oh, that'd be me. Yes, sir. You always have these to think that you know how to do it, Barrett. But I've got one little toy here. I've got limited use of both hands. When I eat, I have to dig with the fork, dig with the spoon, and I can cause problems at times. But I've got this little thing I use when this hand starts cramping up, and it does it pretty often. And when this hand don't know where it's at, and I do this off and on during the day, and it really helped with oblong ball, and got fingers holding in it. The main thing is keeping up one's nutrition and doing that stays a lot of exercise. Probably should have taken jiu-jitsu or something before I started. Gotta realize that when you're eating, you all food is finger food. No matter what it is, the consistency, whatever, it's finger food. And because you try not to, but it ends up that way. So it's best to have your plate set right in front of you. Get one of those long bibs, clean of course, and spread it across the meal and start eating. And by the time you finish, you've got a 100-year-old meal right there in front of you. Finger food. And then, of course, you have to kind of watch your caregivers, because every now and again, you get poked a bit, and mostly on medicine and things like that. So, glance over at her every now and then, make sure she's not getting ready to come over and do the Heimlich on you. Just smile and then try to get it out of there. That's getting her nutrition there. The other part of this is avoiding accidents. I've had a few, learned a lot from them. I have a hospital bed, raising doors, and sometimes I get it too low and expect to be sitting and not there, and don't run, just lean back. Because what you'll do is you'll flip over the mattress and end up doing doing a flip, and your caregiver ain't gonna grade you a grade 10 when you land on your feet, but I did. So you gotta be careful about that. And I guess the other thing is you know, when you're in a bad tub, you gotta be careful with that you don't start going into a Disney on Ice routine. Make sure of all those things are in place, and we pretty much have that been pat now. My vision and my coordination isn't what it was a few months ago, so I have to be real careful. But since I'm the only contrary human being with glaucoma, you're probably pretty clear by then. But seems like there's something else I want to tell you about. And, I can't do it, but anyway, hope you enjoy that, and my next presentation will be on avoiding probably better be about avoid talking. It's over the morning hour, give me. I'll probably post another one a little more serious later on.